Brad Johnson here from johnson.audio, and today I'm going to show you how to set up a reference track in Pro Tools 12 for free. That's right, you don't need any special plugins. All you need is your DAW and an MP3 or WAV file. So this is going to be something that will not work in Logic if you're using Logic. I'm pretty sure it should work in other DAWs. Logic just has a dedicated master fader that it's really hard to work around. I think you can do in the environment, but I don't know really understand the environment, and so I can't tell you how to do it in Logic. If you know how to use environment, you should make a YouTube tutorial on how to do it and enlighten us all. So this is very specific to Pro Tools 12. If you're using Pro Tools 11, I want to let you know that we are using this input monitoring button for this. Pro Tools 11 and below, if it's not HD, does not have the input monitoring, but it does still have the feature. I just think the short key might be Command K, it might be Command I, I don't remember, but if you look up in your toolbar or somewhere, you'll find it. It'll just call it input monitoring, and you can flip between it and do the same thing I'm showing you here. So to set up your reference track, I have all my audio tracks here, and they're all running into a stereo bus aux. So I have it routed to 1 and 2. If you don't know how to set up a stereo bus aux, I'm sure there's plenty of tutorials out there that you can find. It's not that hard. It's super basic DAW kind of stuff. So I would say look it up and you'll figure it out pretty easily. And then I have my stereo bus aux being routed to another audio track. And this is where I'm going to place my reference track. So right now you can see I have a track on here. It's my reference track. And if I just hit play as is without having input monitoring on, you'll hear the reference track. Cool. So you're hearing this track playing, and the reason why you're not hearing all those other tracks is because it's playing into the stereo bus aux, and the stereo bus aux is feeding into the audio track, but because this audio track isn't without the input monitoring button on, it's not listening to what's actually coming out of this, and so you don't hear it. It's muted. And so to hear what's coming through here and to mute what's on this track, because this track is post fader, it's actually happening, so it's the signal flow going into it, you are going to hit the input monitoring button, and now you're hearing my mix. Now you're hearing the reference. Back to the mix. Easy, easy, easy. It's as simple as that. It's quick. You're able to just flip right away, and you're able to hear your reference track against your regular mix. And that's just how you do it. It's as simple as that. Another thing that I want to add here is that it's really good practice to be printing your mix after every session of mixing. So say you take a break, print your mix. If it's at the end of the day, print your mix. And that way you can fly it into this playlist. As you can see, I have different prints in here, and I would have them better labeled if it wasn't for the sake of just this demonstration right now. And that way you know that you're going down the right path later on when you're mixing. The worst thing ever is to waste 8 hours or 9 hours or 10 hours mixing a song, you know, on the second day and then realize that the mix the day before sounds better. So this will help keep you on track and make sure that you're not going down the wrong rabbit hole. Another thing that you want to make sure you're doing is I use clip gain right here just to level match, make sure that my tracks aren't fooling me and that one's louder than the other, and I think the louder one sounds better because the louder always sounds better. So you want to make sure you're level matching using the clip gain. So that right there is how you set up a reference track. This is also how to set up a print track. If you wanted to do a print track, you just have the input monitoring button on again, hit the record enable button, and then record from start to finish, and it'll record your mix. So I hope you got something out of this. If you did, please leave me a comment. If you did get a nugget out of this, a like goes a long way. I appreciate it. And if you haven't subscribed already, please subscribe. And thank you to all my subscribers for supporting this channel. I love being able to share these little tips and tricks I've learned over the years for free with you to alleviate headache, help you along to making better music now. So again, Brad Johnson, johnson.audio, and I'll see you on the next video. Bye.